Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making individual strawberry shortcakes. Some of you probably went on our field trip with us to Cedar Village, which was a restaurant in Urban, Kentucky, which is the next county over. And our purpose in going there was just to show you what local food is like if you eat out at a restaurant where there is home-cooked food. So it's not a chain or anything like that. It's just a single restaurant that's been there for quite a few years, and we've enjoyed the cooking a lot and wanted to share it with you. And most of the things there I have already made in Betty's Kitchen, so I ruled them out immediately. There were maybe a couple of things that I could have made or made variations of. But I sort of zeroed in on the desserts, and there were two desserts there, and I chose to make the strawberry shortcake. For one reason, strawberries are still in season here, and the other dessert, it doesn't really matter what time of year you make that. The other reason is I've been getting some requests lately for strawberry shortcake, so we're going to do our strawberry shortcake, and what I want to do is show you how to get started. Ahead of time, what you need to do is prepare your strawberries. Now, what I have here is half of a quart. I had 1 quart that I was working with of strawberries that were like this. Saved out a couple. I might need them for garnish or something. But you will wash those and take the caps off. And then what I did was to slice them or chunk them into quarters. You can actually slice them and have neat slices if you like. If they're that big, you don't want to leave them whole. And I don't even like having something like this to put on top of a shortcake or in the center of a shortcake. So what I do is take half of the quart and mash it up like this. This is the other half. And put some sugar in. It's 1/4 cup. I've already put it in. That really brings out the syrup of the strawberries. All the juice comes out. So now that I want to place with my original cut up strawberries. So you'll see the beauty of the strawberries from the ones that were cut up, but you'll get the nice juice and more will come out from that sugar if you will add in your mashed strawberries. So I'm going to place some plastic wrap over the top, put this in the refrigerator, and let it stay for a few hours. And then it will be great over our strawberry shortcake. I have my strawberries in the refrigerator, and it's time for us to go ahead and put our mix together for our shortcake. So we're going to start with butter here. I have 1/2 cup, which is 1 stick of butter in here already. Now with that, I'm going to use a little bit of sugar. It's just 2 tablespoons, and I'm going to mix that in. I'm just going to use this pastry blender, and that will get the sugar mixed together with the butter, because I'm getting ready to add the flour, and it's a little easier to take them separately. So we'll take just a little at a time, and this is from 2 cups of self-rising flour. So I'll just keep working on this, and let me go away and get this done, and when I come back, it'll be of the consistency we need to keep moving on with our shortcake. Now this is the type of consistency you want to get when you have blended in the sugar and the flour. So the next thing that we're going to add is some evaporated milk. I have a can right here, but I don't need the whole can. I'm going to be putting in 1/2 cup of evaporated milk. So here goes 1/2 cup. And along with that, I'm going to put some water. I need 1/4 cup of water. So that goes in. Now you can use a fork to blend that together. And by the way, with the pastry blender, you can achieve the same results with a fork. If you're patient with it, you can do that with a fork. So don't feel like you can't make this recipe if you don't have a pastry blender. Now, once I have this stirred together, what I have to do is to put this out on a floured board and knead it 10 to 15 times. So let me get you started on that. And I'll just use my counter here. And I'm going to put a little flour out. You don't have to be exact on this. And then we'll turn the dough out onto the floured surface. It should hang together very well for you, so shouldn't be a problem there. It's a very sticky dough. Try to get all of it. Okay, that's good. And then you might want to flour your hands a little bit before you start this, because you're going to be in the midst of it. Both hands here. And then what you're going to do is get it all together and then just bring it over on itself and then turn. Bring it over and turn. And I'll keep doing this until I've done it about 10 or 15 times. Then it will be ready to roll. After kneading the dough, you'll notice that it is nice and elastic. It doesn't stick to my hands at all, really. It's ready to go. So what I'm going to do is to flour the surface again, and this time be a little more particular with it so it's fairly even. If there's a whole bunch right here, then I want to smooth that out and put this on the surface, put flour on the top, and then take a rolling pin and roll this until it is 1/2 inch thick. So I'll just lay this down and I'll grab some of this flour from around the edge, put it on the top. And then when this is 1/2 inch thick, I'll be back to show it to you. Here's my dough all rolled out, and I lined up some biscuit cutters for you so you can see that you have some choices. You can make these pretty large or you can make them pretty small. Actually, what's going to happen is they're going to be baked in the oven and they will rise a bit, and then you will take them out of the oven when they're done. You'll slice them through the center, just crossways, and then you'll open that, put your strawberry filling over it, and then close it, more strawberry filling, whipped cream, whatever, at the top. It makes a nice individual serving of strawberry shortcake. So Rick says he wants the big one, so I'm taking this one here and just going down, and you've seen me do this on my counter before. I don't want to cut my counter, so I'm just very careful in doing that. You really ought to flour this first. So let me go away and get this done, and I'm just going to get these lifted up and placed in a pan like this. I'll probably put, oh, maybe just two across since these are large. You could put three maybe, but I don't want to crowd them. I've got plenty of space. So we may have 2 by 3, just 6 for demonstration purposes, or I might put more in. We'll see. Here's what I got out of my dough. I started going 4 down the side and then 4 down this side, and then there was room in the middle and I had enough dough for 3 more. So this is all the dough that was left over. So what we're going to do is place these in a 450 degree oven and they will bake for 10 to 12 minutes. And we'll be ready to serve up our strawberry shortcake. My individual shortcakes have cooked for 8 minutes. That's all they needed at the 450 degrees. And you can see what they look like. We wouldn't want them any dunner than that, any browner. And I'm going to serve them up to you. I want to show you how to put together an individual strawberry shortcake. Here we have our shortcakes, and I've taken a couple of them and worked with them already. They're very loose, they're still warm. I wouldn't do this when they are just straight out of the oven, that would be too hot. So when it's warm, just slice it with a knife like this. This is a steak knife actually, some kind of knife, but just in half horizontally as it would look as a biscuit, and open it up, and then put your strawberries and juice on the bottom half, and that juice will soak in and make a really wonderful shortcake. So that's the bottom. Bring the cap up to the top and do the same thing again. So just put plenty of chunks of strawberries or slices if you've done it that way, and then there will be juice and pulp as well. Let me put another one there on top to look pretty. Well, it fell off. There we go. And then if you want to make it a little extra special, put some whipped topping on top of that, or beside it, wherever you like. This is kind of hiding those strawberries. Maybe if I turn it toward you, you can see what we have. And then decorate it up maybe with a whole strawberry. And there we have our individual strawberry shortcake. If you choose to put two on a plate, then that's really nice too. You can have a double individual serving of strawberry shortcake. Enjoy!